In this video, we're going to talk about a multi-agent reasoning loop and what that means. So maybe you've thought, hey, what if I stuck two AI agents together and had one look at what the other one just put out? I would be able to create an infinite loop of AI agents able to build off of each other and think and, you know, critique each other. And that's literally what we're talking about right here, actually. In fact, we don't have to necessarily build an infinite chain of agents. We can actually use a loop. We use a loop that allows us to be able to put some data in and then have AI agents examine it, critique it, update it, consider whether it's good enough to be able to process to move further. And then once it reaches a certain point, then they can exit the loop and allow that information to pass on. And so here, I'll just show you a really quick example. I've just got a click trigger here, and I've got something called product description, and I've just got a tech product to help struggling carpenters, just as an example. And so what this whole agent is going to do is it's going to take that and it's going to develop some ideas for a brand name. So we have a creative branding agent. It's going to come up with three distinct names and tagline options for our company. So we're going to ahead and run this. What's going to happen is it's going to give me three items, and we'll see them over here. We have three items, but it's just a string. All right. It's shaped like an array, but it's actually just a string. And that's gonna be important here in a second because I have an edit fields note. But before I go into that, I'm gonna talk about our other AI agents and what they do and why they're helpful. And so what we have is we have this, everything that came out of this one agent that gave us our initial ideas is then gonna send it through a loop. And that loop is going to have a critic agent, it's gonna have a refiner agent, and an evaluation agent. Now, the critic agent is supposed to just be a critical branding analyst or just an analyst of some type who's going to take a look, and it's going to provide a short description of any flaws in what it sees and make suggestions for improvements. We then have a refining agent that's going to take the original inputs, it's going to take the critique, and it's going to try its best to come up with an improvement on what came through it. So this is a refiner, uses original ideas and the critic's feedback to create three improved names and tagline combinations, all right? And it's gonna output an array. And then all of that is gonna go through an evaluation agent. And this evaluation agent takes a look at all of those things and it's gonna decide, you know, which of them is number one, which is number two, which is number three. And then it's also gonna decide, you know, do we have a winner? Are any of these like truly, and like here I have, is so awesome that it would make anyone want to purchase from this company. Now, this is just an example. You would obviously set up your bots to be able to evaluate your information how you want. I'm trying to be a little silly here in order to be able to just demonstrate how this works. But this evaluation agent makes a determination whether or not this is good enough to be able to say, yes, this is what we want. All right, and so what we're gonna do is I showed you what happens, but let me go ahead and show you the remaining nodes because they kind of matter here. The edit fields node is going to take the information that comes into the loop. My loop is actually set up as a reset loop. You'll see this here. So if you don't see this option, it's just under options, click that, it'll open up this one, turn that on. And what this one does, it means that every single time something comes through this loop, it's gonna act as if this is the first time it's ever seen anything come through. So this is not necessarily for multiple items. It's not necessarily designed to be able to process. Like I have loops in my report writing documents. We have five sections in my report. It's gonna write 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It's not necessarily designed to do that. This is designed to see one thing at a time. It's gonna treat it just one thing, and it's gonna loop over and over and over again until either it crashes or it outputs something good. All right. And then what we do is here, we have an edit fields node that's gonna take the information from our original AI agent, but we're just doing a JSON.output, and it's .output because over here, we're gonna have an output as well on this other edit fields node. So at the beginning and end, we're gonna have an edit fields node that's gonna be able to take the input, and it's gonna output the same thing that it's expecting to input into it. All right, and that allows us to have our loop. All right, and so we're gonna have an item called just ideas. It's gonna be set as an array. It's an array because this output an array over here, and this last agent is going to output an array as well. You'll see here, it's formatted as an array down here. Okay, and so we're taking an array. We're gonna have an item called turn. You can call it execution or pass or whatever you want to call it. what this is tracking is the number of times that the loop has gone around. And you want, we do that in combination with this code node over here, which I'll explain in a second, in order to be able to check whether we should be done or not. All right. And so what we're going to do is we have that set. It's going to put out our number of turns, which is set at the end edit fields node. I'll talk about that in a moment, or set it to number one because it's the first time, one of the two. And we also have one set to done. So either we're going to have something that is an indication of yes, this is done, or a no, that's not done based on what the evaluation agent comes up with, or we want to set it to no as an initial. We then pass it through an if node. The if node is checking whether the number of turns has passed a certain number five in this case, or done is set to yes, meaning the evaluation agent has determined that this is all good. We then pass it through our critic agent, pass it through our refiner agent, pass it through our evaluation agent, and the evaluation agent's output should be put through some sort of code like this, where it takes the number of turns that come in, it then determines, you know, how many turns we've done, and then it adds one each time. It then will then pass through all the information with our new number of turns and whether this is done or not, as well as the ideas that came out of the evaluation agent. So we output a nice JSON just like this. We have our ideas, our turn, and our done. And again, you can name these whatever you want for your specific information. I'm just trying to get you to understand the concept of what we're doing here. All right, and then we pass that all through one more edit field node that then resets it all to be the same structure with the same input, you know, field names as the original edit fields that we have in order to make sure everything lines up. It's nice and clean. I just always make sure I always have edit fields nodes on the beginning and end of every loop just in case. All right, and so that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna just go ahead and run it, and we're gonna see what it outputs. So it's gonna go ahead and run. It's gonna come up with some brand names and taglines for tech business that helps carpenters. It's gonna go ahead and run through. We go through once. Most likely it's gonna say, oh, it actually thinks it came up with a solution on our first pass. That's interesting. So we got Woodwise Smart Solutions for Expert Craftsmen. That's actually, it came up with a great idea the first time through. Craft Composition, Smart Tools for Skilled Hands, not so great. Saw Pro Eds, Precision Tech at Your Fingertips, that's not so great. So it actually did come up with a really good one in the first run through. Let's run it again, see if we can't get it to maybe not necessarily do so good the first time, because I want to actually show you this working. If not, I'll have to go back to my executions. And I did do one that didn't come out so well. It did like four passes. Okay, here, we did a second turn through. It's doing another pass. It's again, everything that the refiner agent is coming up with, it's going through the evaluation agent. The evaluation agent goes, yes, it's good enough to pass on, or no, we're not ready to pass it on. In which case the refiner agent then acts as like our original input agent that came up with our first set of information that then gets critiqued and then gets refined again. And then it goes through another set of evaluation. In this case, it went through twice. So let's see what it came up with this time. We came up with Edgecraft, Precision Woodworking Tools Forged for Artisans as our number one choice it did. Brainmaster, Master Your Craft with Tools That Perfect Every Grain, nah. Shapemen, Sculpting Tools Inspiring Creators to Craft Boldly. I'm not so much a fan of that. Edgecraft might be okay. Precision Woodworking Tools Forged for Artisans. It's a decent name, Just be aware, like my prompts here were junk, absolute junk. I was doing this just to be able to show you kind of how this might work. Obviously, you want to make sure you have good system prompts that clearly instruct the agent on what it is you're trying to accomplish, what it is you want to do. I'll go ahead and put a video link in the description below on good prompting techniques to help you understand how to be able to develop these out. But that's it. That's how you can set up a multi-agent reasoning loop. You need some sort of input, you need to run it through a loop that then has a critic, a refiner, and then an evaluation agent, and then format the data so that it can come back around through once more and then go through over and over again until it reaches a point that either it hits that number five turn, meaning that it went through five different iterations. You know, you can set that number to whatever you want, but you just don't want it to go through too many that this is just running forever and ever and ever and never gonna end, because that's just gonna waste your tokens. Or it ends up being completed, so it's a done as in yes, and then it's ready to move forward. And then you just pass it through. So then this AI, this branch here of the if node, which is yes, could then go through maybe another AI agent that then does something with that input, and then it continues the process into the rest of your workflow. So if you found this tutorial helpful, please make sure to subscribe to the channel, like and share the video. It really does help get this information out there to those who need it. And if you want more helpful n8n tutorials or a bunch of free workflows, please look to join our free school community. The link is in the description below. I've got workflows for social media posting, personal assistants, marketing plan generators, and so much more for all different types of businesses. It's all available for free right in my school community. As always, I'm Bradford Carlton. Let's automate your success together.